As a data analyst, you're going to come across primarily three types of data. Now, there are other data types, but I'm actually going to focus on the three major types of data that you're going to be encountering. The reason this is important is because the data type should actually influence or dictate the type of analysis that you should be running. So hopefully I'll go through the three data types and give you an idea of what kind of data they are and the types of analysis that you should be running on them. The first type of data is called parametric or numerical data. Now, this is data that you will probably be most familiar with. So that's things like age, things like height, weight, anything that's continuous, okay? That's normally parametric or numerical data. It can also be discrete. So for example, height is continuous, so you could have like loads of small intervals in between different people, but you may also have then discrete data like counts. So for example, transactions is a good one. You can't have 1.5 transactions, you've got actual whole number transactions. So in terms of numerical data or parametric data, you have continuous or discrete, but they're usually things that go up and down in a very ordered way. When you're running analysis on this type of data, this is where typically you would run things like regression, things like t-test, anything that allows you to use sort of that linear data is very good. And this is usually good when you're trying to understand if something performed better than something else, okay? So you might say, okay, how many sales were there based on condition one versus condition two? So what you find is, you know, that's the kind of data that you will encounter, that continuous parametric numerical data that you would use sort of analysis like regression, t-test to analyze, or even ANOVA. So the second type of data is non-parametric or categorical data, and there's two types of data in that. The first one is nominal, which means it has no order. So for example, country is an example of categorical data where it has no order. You can't rank a country by itself, okay? You may rank country by another measure, but country in itself can't be ordered. Gender is another one, so there's no order, it's just nominal. You're either male or female, okay? So you have in the categorical, the non-parametric state, nominal data. But then you also have ordinal data, and you'll be quite familiar with this. This is the kind of data that does have an order, but it's actually a category. So for example, you may run a survey about how satisfied are you with a service or something, and you would have something like, you know, very dissatisfied, satisfied, neutral, satisfied, and very satisfied. So they're ordinal data. They have an order, but they're categorical, okay? And there's no in-between. So you're either satisfied or not satisfied, you're either neutral or you know, satisfied or dissatisfied. So that's the second type of data, and a lot of the analysis on that will be trying to either predict certain things. So you might want to predict male, female, in which case you might use something like classifications or decision trees or even logistic regression. Or what you might be wanting to do is look at if something happens more than another. So for example, you might be looking at something where you go, do people from certain ethnicities are more likely to pass the exam than not? Okay, so you might run something like a chi-square, which looks at the probability of an occurrence happening than not happening. In terms of like categorical data, in terms of surveys and stuff where you have satisfaction on a scale of 1 to 5, you do need to use non-parametric statistical techniques. Using parametric ones aren't always relevant. So for example, a classical example is correlation. So a lot of people know how to use Pearson's correlation coefficient, but Pearson's is really for parametric, the numerical stuff we talked about, whereas for categorical data, you'd be using Spearman's row to do that. So even though you can run, the statistical test will run on any type of data, it won't matter. What you as the data analyst need to make sure that you're running the right test for the right type of data. And then the final data set is a string data or text data, okay? And this is things like name, address, you know, descriptions of things. And, you know, there are now obviously techniques from the data science space like natural language processing, text analytics that will help you analyze that data, okay? But typically what data analysts would do was take the text data, try to create a thematic or categorical values out of it through some simple sort of, you know, counts or simple identification of certain tags, okay? But that data is, for data analysts, pretty much used for description more than it is used for analysis. Now, those are the three main data types. So you've got parametric, continuous, or numerical data, you've got non-parametric or categorical data, and then you've got text or string data. There are other data types which aren't really used by data analysts, but are used by data scientists, and they're things like audio, they're things like vision, images, audiovisual images. So, you know, that kind of stuff that data scientists can analyze and extract values from in order to run models or do some analysis. So if you're a data analyst, you should really know the three core types of data that you'll be working with and make sure that you apply the the right analytics to the right data set. Well, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do like and share the video and look out for future videos.